Now, coming to the third question, and this is something I would like, most of the conflicts in today's world, especially related to mother-in-laws, so they are generally people blame the mother-in-law or the daughter-in-law. And sometimes, but if you really analyze these issues, like what is the root cause of this conflict? And the main two, three things which come about is suspicion, jealousy, and lack of attention. And all these three things, some or the other way, is related to the son himself, the husband in between. And most of the times, you find that the husband is given a very clean chit in this regard. He's supposed to be sandwiched between them. But do you think that somewhere down the line, we as a community, we are raising our sons to be money minting machines and do not actually inculcate in them the way to resolve relationship conflicts or how to deal with relationships? That thing is not taught to them. So what do you think about this? That what can we do in this?
Absolutely. As I said before, it lies in our hands, right? As mothers, as when we are raising a next generation, what you inculcate in your children, be it sons or daughters, that's what is going to matter, right? So we focus a lot on the women, on the daughters, on grooming them to become better mothers and better housewives, but not much is happening on the other end, which is the sons. But alhamdulillah, I do see that a lot of sisters, a lot of mothers nowadays are trying to inculcate this habit of equality in justice. I'm not saying equal means where both of them get the same same type of love and affection. Yes, they are supposed to get it, but I'm talking about in terms of justice, you know. So I always prefer just to equality, because equality, what may seem equal to us may not seem equal to others. But then justice is not like that. Just has two sides. You listen to two sides and then you do it. And that's what this book is actually about. The mother-in-law has a, so this book here with you has three point of views. There's a mother-in-law's point of view, daughter-in-law's point of view, and the son's point of view, the son slash husband, his point of view. So through the book, you do get to understand that each of them have their own feelings. Each of them go through their own stuff. So, like, you know, right now I'm here as a daughter-in-law in my, in my family, I'm here as a daughter-in-law. But I'm sure my mother-in-law has her own stuff going on. You know, it doesn't mean that only I have, let's say, hormonal issues. Even she has hormonal issues, right?
True.
So I blame my acting on my hormones. What about her? What about the husband? What is he doing? You know, he has his own work tension. So all of us have stories behind us, and in our stories, we feel we are the, we are the main characters, and the others are just extra characters. But if we do think about it, and we think that, how do I put myself forward? How do I be a better person so that I can bring in a change, and that change will affect my husband, my mother-in-law, and then they, inshallah, in turn, would become better versions themselves. So, to answer your question of how to get the sons, in the right track, it's in the mother's hands. They should be the one who should be teaching about it, because once they're grown, you know. So, yeah, it should be the
That's what
sister.
actually it also comes once again to the daughter-in-law also, how she is training her kid. Her kid is ultimately going to become somebody's husband. So I think it all well, basically comes back to the tarbiyah. And
Exactly.
that is and obviously I also like that point, about placing each other's shoes. We always see the world through one way, through our way. We do not see about how the other person is feeling. That's true.